Last session we talked about what is machine learning, what is AI, what is deep learning. Guys, the most important thing is we must have an Anaconda on your system. So Sandeep, did you try to download the Anaconda on your system?
Yes, sir, I downloaded, but it was not installing, sir. It was asking somewhat, it was like showing me go to Play Store.
Yes, everyone should have the Python editor, that is Anaconda, that should be installed. So please download Anaconda for Python. Just search for the Anaconda for Python in Windows, you have to select. Okay, so once you download that one, install it with the steps, you are going to get the all the packages which are related to the machine learning, which are available in the Anaconda. The most important thing is NumPy, SciPy, Panda, and actually used for the graphs. Okay, Pandas is for the data analysis. SciPy is having multiple sub packages inside that, and you can also use them for your robotic programs. Okay, so these are the packages you should have in the Anaconda. So once you install Anaconda, you can just go to start button, click the Anaconda navigator. It will be taking some time and it will launches the software site within your system. So the site means when you are going to use the browser, it is opens that one, right? So this is also uses the browser and loads that one. Okay. So today our topic is try to understand what is Python data types. Okay, so whenever I launch the Anaconda, it is keep on popping up multiple command windows. After that, it is going to work. So let me go through the data types in Python. So Python data types, there are two types of data. Okay, there are two types of Python variables. Okay, one is mutable, second one is immutable object. So when you're working with this mutable, immutable, what is the difference? We should understand. Take the example so that you can understand very, very easily. Okay, so in general, any data type, I'm going to take, it is going to have a data inside a variable. Suppose I'm going to say x is equal to 10. X is a variable, 10 is a value. Okay, so x is a variable that is going to have multiple ways you can assign the values and you can change the value. Okay, so let us go through this. So let me go through these data types, then I will come to your screen and I will show you.
Okay sir.
Yeah. Okay, so there are two types of variables, mutable and immutable. Why it is called mutable? What is the meaning of mutable, immutable? So the types are given in the same screen, you can see, right? Immutable variables are int, float, long, complex, string, tuple, frozen set. These are all immutable. Means once you assign the value to the variable, then it is going to store permanently in the RAM. Okay, so once that variable you are going to store with a new value, it doesn't accept the new value. It is going to take another value, another variable. Again, it will create a new memory location for that. Okay. So if you want to check where it is creating, what is the identity for that particular variable, you can just use a function called ID. Okay. So we'll see one of these, what is this and how that is going to work. So here, if you take mutable objects, we are having byte array, list, set, dictionary. These are the four variable values which you can change dynamically. Anytime you can change the values in the list, in the set, in the dictionary, the byte array. Okay, if you are going for the immutable object, if I'm going to take name is a variable. If I'm going to store name is equal to Sandeep Teja. Okay, so if I'm going to use the name variable, next time I'm going to store another name. Let's say I want to store the name variable with the Pavan. Then the first time when it is used, one memory location, let's say 1000 address in the memory, it is having a 1000 address. Okay, so that stored the Sandeep Teja. Second time I stored Pavan, name is equal to Pavan. So this new memory location will be created and it will be storing the new value, but it doesn't use the same memory location. It doesn't replace the existing memory location. Okay, so that is a string or tuple also do the same thing. Frozen set also do the same thing. All immutable objects will work in the same fashion. We'll see one of these examples so that you can understand that better. Okay, so what is this types, why we are having list, set, dictionary, what is the meaning of all of them, we'll see one after the other in detail. So Python is having the basic built-in data types, that is called standard data types, Boolean type, numeric type, sequence type, list, tuple that comes into sequences. Sets, there are two types of sets, right? So one is a frozen set, another one is normal set. So set, whatever you think in the mathematics, x value can range from 1, 2, 3 like that. It will go up to the 10, that is one set. The same way here also we can store a set into a variable. Okay, so mapping, what is mapping? Mapping is a one of the variable where you can have let's say student Raghav, or if you are going to take another variable, trainer Sandeep, or if you are going to take another variable like director Kalaja. So these are all different variables which are having a mapping, and name of that indicates the value. If you don't have a trainer variable, you cannot get the who is a trainer. If you are going to search for a student, you don't know who is a student. Okay, so mapping is nothing but two sets. One set is having the keys, another set is having the values. Okay, so if you look at all these variables, basic types, Boolean means true or false, numeric means you are going to have some number value, 10, 20 or 0.5 or 10.5, all these are called numeric type. Sequences, you are going to have list. Okay, so list, you can give 10, 50, 30 is a list, or you can give the all the cities, Hyderabad, Secunderabad, it's a cities list. Okay, so like that you can create your own sequences, you can create your own tuples. So lists and tuples are comes under sequences. Okay, so basically there are how many types? These are the basic types: Boolean type, numeric type, sequence type, sets, maps. Okay, so in each type again you are having mutable, immutable. So what are mute, what are immutable? Means immutable means you cannot change. Mutable means you can change the value anytime. Okay, so let us see one of these basic type, Boolean type. So Boolean type is the type which we are going to have the true or false values. You can check the values, it is going to give the result in 0 or 1. Okay, so if you are going to say 1, that is a true. Okay, so for example here we have couple of examples. True means 1 is greater than 0, it is a true, it is going to give the true. So 1 is greater than or equal to 1 means that is also true. 1 is less than 2, that is true. 1 is less than or equal to 1, it is also true, right? So these are all different conditional statements. Now we'll work with a set. Okay, here we have a set 1, 2, 3. So 1 is in one of this set, 1 belongs to this set. So you can say 1 in 1, 2, 3, it is true. If I'm going to say here 5 in 1, 2, 3, then it is going to say false, right? So if you are going to have the general English combination, not zero means one. So whenever you are getting a result as one, that is a true. In Python, one means true, zero means false. Okay, so we'll test one of these examples and try to understand how we can use it. So whenever you start an Anaconda navigator, it will ask you this one. Okay, don't show again. So you also try to open your Anaconda. Whenever you start learning, you put every day one notebook. So what you are going to write, that notebook is this one. Jupyter Notebooks is a web-based notebook, and you can write, you can test all your learnings here. Test that one and see that one, and you can comment there itself. If it is working, not working, you test it and store that one. So it will be remain in that page only, in the notebook. So generally, whenever you attend a class, you'll be writing notes, right? So same way, you are writing something about the Boolean type. So you are going to test that Boolean type variables testing, then you are going to use that, right? Open, right? So it is loaded. Okay, you want to open a new one, new notebook. You can open new one. So in the notebook, you just click file and new. So it will be opening a new page for you. Insert cell below after that, also you can do Python 3. Okay, so now we are ready to test our Python programs or learnings. So if I want to test one is greater than is greater than 10, is it true or false? What is expected result?
False.
So it is giving the false. Okay, so if I'm going to give the same variable 10 less than 1, is it correct? Is it true or false? That's fine. Okay, 10 is greater than 4. It's true or false? So just simple greater than less than symbols we have, right? You can test the values and use that one. So Boolean type, this is a Boolean type. So Boolean is giving the true or false values. True or false. Okay, the conditions you try to understand. So 10 is greater than or equal to. If I'm going to give equal to, equality is making equality check also. So it will check with the 10 and check. So you are going to get true. Okay, so the same thing you can also test for the less than or equal to. So equal to always true, that's why you are going to get the true value. Okay, so different Boolean types we have tested. Boolean types, true, false, all this entire slide is available online. To try with all these examples, okay. So try with the set. Okay, this one we need to test the list. If I'm going to have a list, that how can I use? So let's say x is equal to 10 I have, and y is equal to I'm having a list. Okay, so the list can be square brackets we have to use. I'm giving 10 comma 20 comma 30. Okay, I want to test that x in y. So this is the condition I want to test. So I got that true. So x is present in y. So x in y, that is true, right? So the same thing, if I want to use the test a tuple also, let me try a is equal to 5 and b is equal to tuple, we are going to give in round brackets. Okay, So 1, 4, 5, 9. So this is the tuple I'm taken. Four elements are present. Out of this, 5 is present or not. I just want to test A in B. This I want to test. It is present. If I'm going to test the same thing and I want to check that one, A value 50. And I want to test this same. So what should be done? The result A, that 50 is present in 1459. It is false. Okay, so simple, very, very general English. Anybody can understand Python. It is very easy, right? So Boolean operations we have done so far. All right. Another set of examples also there. You just open this one and try to execute in your Jupyter notebook so that whatever you have done, you can show me on the notebook itself. Okay. So I hope you can do all of this. Yeah.
What is the difference between this list and a set?
We are coming to that. Right now, we are just checking the Boolean type.
Oh,
yeah. Okay. We'll come to that. Sure. The numeric types. So if you are going to see numeric types, these are the numeric types. In real time projects, all these are C language. If you know C language, the C is having the float type numeric value and long type. So the biggest memory allocation which can be allocated with the long data type. Okay, and these numeric types, we can also have not only signed numbers. In if you look for the C programming, you are having signed integer, unsigned integer. These are all different types of integers. But in Python, int means it will cover everything. What is a signed integer? Signed integer means anybody? Any idea? No idea? Okay, so if you take the number on a graph, your number will be plotted on the graph on x-axis, and the midpoint starts from the zero, and it will go towards the two directions. That increasing number will be increasing towards the both the directions. Okay, 0, 1, 2, 3 in the right side. In the left side, we are having after the zero, -1, -2, -3, right? So that is called minus negative numbers. So negative number, positive numbers. Combinedly, if you are going to store something, you want to write into a variable, then we are going to use a integer object, int object. Okay. So the same thing, just now we have seen x, y, a, whatever the values we have tested, those variables are nothing but integer type. Okay. So how can I know that is a integer type? How can I know this is a type of long type or float type? Okay, so there are certain examples given in the same where the PowerPoint is available on the same blog page. You can see that. Okay, so you just go to that. Let me just go to this page. So this is a blog page of Python orientation blogspot.com. Okay, in that one, this page is about the data types. Okay, so these data types, all data types are executed, tested. So you just try all these examples on your Python Anaconda Jupyter notebook. Okay, so here, what are the types are there? How we can test? How to open the Jupyter notebook? First, go to your navigator, this one. Click on the notebook launch. It will pop up 3 times command window. After that, it will give the browser page. Okay, it will be opened in your Chrome. So I'm getting this in the my Chrome page. So once it is open, you just open a new file and try to save there itself. Okay, so right now I have a couple of variables x, y, a, b, etc. So what is this type? Data types I'm saying, what type it is? a is equal to 50. It is an integer, I am saying. But how computer knows it is a 50. So let me just say a type a, right? So what it is going to give? It is giving me integer type. It stored 50, so I got integer here. Okay. So if I am going to test that a is equal to y, y is a list, right? So if you see that list, so here it is a list type. If I'm going to say p is equal to 5.6, whatever point value, right? So if I'm going to say type p, then it is having the real number, point number 6. That is a float. Okay, if I'm going to give number, so what is the bigger? I don't know. Then you can take a biggest, lengthiest number and give L, that is a long type. Okay, so I just store that L is equal to this number. Okay, so we have the page here and go through this. There are a lot of functions related to every data type. Okay, so we are having a couple of data types. Okay, so we have a couple of data types. You try with these examples, whatever given in the blog page, go with them. Okay, so list and tuples, one common thing is they are sequences. Okay, so if I'm going to have you already created one folder. It is untitled folder. So you type there and save that file. It will be there. We will see that one later on. Once the session is ending, at the end of the session, I will see. Okay, right. So the tuple and list, these are the two important things we will see. Okay, so here I'm having a tuple. Here y is a list and b is a tuple. So if I'm going to see that type b, and yeah, this one I want to check what is it. So b is a tuple. So whenever you are using a b, what is the b contains? Round brackets and a sequence of numbers. Any random numbers you store, that is integer numbers, it is called a tuple. So whenever you want to store a tuple, you have to use the first rule is rounded brackets. Okay, and if I'm going to store something, any names, let's say names, I'm giving n as a names. Okay, so and then I use Sandeep. Okay, so these are all string elements. These are called names, right? So when I'm using this, what is the type? Type n. So if I check this one, it is again a tuple. Okay, and how can I access this tuple? This n, if I'm going to access, I want to get Sandeep out of this one. How do I get? Tuple and list works with the index values. Tuple and list. So if I'm going to take a list, student list, students is equal to, I'm giving square brackets. Okay, then I'm giving the Naveen. All right, so these are names of the students. Okay, if I'm going to check that, names, the study student names. I'm just using the variable std. So it is giving list. Okay. So these two things, tuple and list, do the same type of storage, right? It is storing, n is storing four names, list is also storing n. So what is the difference between these two? So if I'm going to use dir n, so dir will tells you how many functions associated with the tuple object. So what are the functions? If I'm saying dir, it is showing all its functions. So these are all the functions. Okay, so tuple is having limited functions, count, index. So how many names are there? Then I can say n dot in dot tuple. Okay, let us see, just n is printing or not first. Print, what is n value? Yeah, it's coming as is this. And if I want to print normally, print n square bracket, so the name of the index value, it will work actually. Vinaya, I want to get, then the value will be index value 0. So index value, I got Vinaya here. Okay, if I'm changing the value to 3, I'll get the Sandhi. Okay, so index 0, 1, 2, 3. Okay, if I want to get Suresh, what should I give? That two, right? So this is how we can access the tuple. So tuple is having two functions. These two functions, how it is going to work? Just want to print n dot count. Let's see. Now brackets required or not? That is. And for this thing, count is coming. Count is up. Maybe you need to explore on n dot count. Function, how it should work. Value. Okay, it will count how many times occurred, I think. So, yeah. So if I'm going to have a n value, again, n is equal to round bracket values. So I have a new tuple I'm creating. So n value, I want to test n dot count, right? So how many times it occurred? Let us see. Count. Puppy got two times in this, so that is how the count will work, right? And yeah, so n dot index, what it is taking, three parameters, I think. So where it is occurred, and then if I'm going to say so second time where it is occurred, fifth position, fifth index value. So first time puppy occurred at 0 and 1. So 1 is the index value. The next time whenever puppy occurred, that is in position 5, index 5. So if you look at 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, right? So 5 is the result you got. So second time puppy occurred at index value 5. Okay. So two functions only you can do when you're working with the tuple. Only two. So if you go for the list, okay, so we have a list, right? STD. Let me go with the STD. I'm going to say print students list, right? So if I'm going to take the students list, these are the student list. In this student list, if I want to add a new student or I want to change any student, I can change. Okay, so std dot append, then you can give Vasu. I just added here a new student. So this student is added to what? After the Praveen, you will be getting Vasu. Okay, so let me just print bracket std. It is executed two times. Previously it is added, again one more time this append is executed, that's why you got the, okay. So if you want to do the same thing, append, adding the new element, n cannot add new element, okay. So n is a new, cannot change, cannot use any append function. The difference, Sandeep, you were asking, right? So if you want to add any element to the existing list, existing values, you cannot add any new element in the n. So if I am going to try to n add n dot append, so append function itself not available. If I try to add, right, so this operation is not allowed. It is saying error. Okay, tuple object has no attribute append. Cannot append. So how I got this one, this clarification about list and tuple means dir is the best option. It will gives you all the functions present in that particular object. Okay, so std is going to give all the functions. So all underscore functions are called magical functions, which are automatically available, but which are not having underscore, those functions you can use. Okay, so if you don't understand the function, you try there, it will show the syntax, what are the parameters you can give on that one. And again, help also available, and in the internet also you will get more functionality. So append means you can add any new element to the list. Okay, so std is your list. I can add new element anytime, n number of times I can add. Okay. Okay, I'll try add one more time. Let us see. And see the print value std. Got it? So you can add. Right, so this appending is not available because it is tuple is immutable. Immutable means you cannot add anything to the existing. Once store that you cannot change. Okay, so you can delete some elements from the list using the pop, using the remove. These are the functions. You can insert in between. In between Raghav and Naveen, you want to insert. how to insert. Insert is a function.
Yes.
Std dot want to insert. What is the index value? 0, 1. So after 1, you want to insert an element. Insert. Okay. And let us give the index value. Where should I give? I don't know. Let's try. Is giving an error. Insert object. What is functionality? Don't know. Then let us just give the insert first number, then string. This is accepted. Then print std. So you can insert any time in between the elements. This is also not possible in the tuple. Inserting is not possible. Appending is not possible. Okay, let me just try n dot insert. Right. So I want to add after the 3, John. Okay, so let's say, but it is saying error. Object no attribute. That insert function itself not available. Attribute, these are all what you are getting from the dir, that is an attribute. Okay, so what is the difference between list and a tuple? We have seen almost similar functions. Okay, so you can delete elements, you can pop elements. Let us see this pop function also. Std.pop. Right now, what is the std? Let us see print. Okay, then std.pop, then print. Okay, so before and after pop, what is happening? You want to. So before pop, this is, so whatever the last element is there, that will be deleted. So pop is deleted from the list. Pop means removing the last element. Suppose I want to delete one particular element. So how can I delete? So remove is another function you have. You remove, how we can remove? Std dot remove. Then if I want to give 3, what does it do? You have to give the element. Right. So it is removed. Okay. Now try to print. Print std. So Vijay is deleted. Okay. So what if Vasu you want to delete? Then what happens? Does it remove 2 elements or not? What do you think? The number of occurrences it is going to. So, right. So let us see. The last element is removed first. So once again, you run this one element again, print that. The next was is also deleted. Okay. So remove function is there, and you can also do sorting. You can do extending. You can add more and more elements. All at a time you want to extend, you can extend. So let's say x is equal to, what is this extend? Okay, so this is the x, and I want to extend. Std dot extend. I want to extend the list. STD student list with X. Okay, and then I want to print. Now students list is last elements plus Vasu, Vijay, Vas is added. Right? Any questions? Yeah, that. So guys, any question, Naveen, Sun?
How do you sorting?
Sort. Alphabetically, it is going to sort. STD dot sort. It's the function, and you can run. So if you are going to print, then you'll be getting sort. This is a sorted list. First capital letters, then lowercase. So lowercase n, these are all B starting letters, capital letters. So this is the first. Then next priority, alphabetically, if you look at the first character, M, N, O, P, P, Q, R, R, right? So this is a sorted list of alphabetical names. Okay. So list, you can store anything, any numbers, number list, right? So if I'm going to have a list, square bracket, right? So 50, 22, or 9, something, 45, or 444. Randomly, I have picked some numbers. And if I'm going to say numbers list dot, okay, number list dot sort, then print. All the increasing order, okay, so it is giving the sorted order. Reverse sort. Reverse is also there. If I'm going to say num list, number list dot reverse. Then print list. Reverse. The tuple is an exercise for you, and go to the page what I have shown, execute all of them, all these examples, and we just covered only up to the some number of slides. What are the slides we have covered so far? Lists and tuple we have covered. Strings we are not done. Strings in the next session we will cover. List examples, whatever we have here from the 17 slide onwards, you have 17, 18, 19, 20. All these list examples, you try to work with your Jupyter notebook. Execute all of them, try to see, and you can get all of them working. Okay. List, after list, you have tuple also. So many examples. So after that, tuple is given. And try to execute all of these also, these examples. Length of the function, and try to work with the multiplying star plus how it is working. Concatenating also you test. Okay, whatever the examples are given there, try to work with up to from 17 to 24, all the slides execute. Test and follow this blog page. Try to work with all these examples. Okay. So if you have any questions, do let me know. We'll connect next week, Saturday, 11 o'clock. Thank you, guys.